If you've ever played any of the old Game Boy Pokemon games, you may have come across Pokemon FireRed version. It is reboot of the old Pokemon. Go back to when I was younger and purchased the FireRed version. So I went to nearby GameStop and looked in the used Game Boy games. I found a somewhat old-looking FireRed and decided to look elsewhere. I finally found one at a yard sale for $5, and thinking the buy was a steal, bought the game happily. The game cartridge was nice and new-looking, other than my few scratches. I turned the cartridge over to see if the label was correct, and I noticed that there was some masking tape in place of the label. FireRed was written in black marker, but the writing was in the unknown language. The unknown language is the type of Pokemon who are in different forms, each unknown is in the shape of a letter. Anyways, the masking tape had unknown spelling FireRed on it. Confused, I put the game in my old Game Boy Advance SP and continued to play. The Game Freak logo came up as usual, but the opening scene with Gengar and the Nidorino was missing. Figuring it was a simple glitch, I shook it off, and I continued. Everything was normal until I got to the Star Pokemon. These Pokemon were black and white instead of normal red and white. This disturbed me a bit, but I figured it could be the game glitching again. I continued playing and chose the odd-looking Charmander. I nicknamed it Blaze, which was the name I gave my old Charmander from my childhood. I got to the rival battle and set out Blaze. The rival sent out a ghost, the type of ghost from the Lavender Town Tower, which name actually escapes me. I attempted to harm the ghost, but after 10 minutes of Blaze is too scared to move, I raged and switched off the Game Boy. After calming down, I went back to the game and switched the Game Boy back on, expecting to start a new game, because it didn't save the first game I created. I was disturbed to see Blaze still in battle. Angrily, I kept hitting the ghost, but to no avail. Suddenly, the battle ended with neither of us winning. The screen went black for around 10 seconds before I attempted to turn the Game Boy off. I switched it off and thought it was finally off, but the Lavender Town music started up with a black screen. That music has always frightened me since I was a child, so it's definitely frightening to hear it so right. The screen slowly faded to black and showed Charmander being engulfed by the ghost's misty body. A deafening Charmander cry, even at a lower pitch than normal, blurred out of the tiny Game Boy speakers. The mist had swallowed up Charmander, and the whole screen was pixelated ghost body. The screen again faded to black. At this point, I was crying slightly. I was horrified at what I bought. But the Game Boy was still on and was 8 feet away from me. Just because I've thrown out of fear. Suddenly, the ghostly mist became seeping from the screen speakers. Terrified, I ran to the other side of the room, but the door was jammed. No way out. I stared horrifically at the growing mass of mist. I saw movement within the cloud of mist, what looked like a tiny Charmander's hand. But there was something wrong with the hand. It was decayed and looked almost burnt. The hand reached out of the mist, and I saw the rest of it. It was Blaze, from my older game. He was holding the old Everstar, given to keep it from evolving. Blaze slowly crept towards me. His eyes were non-existent, just empty sockets. His jaw broken and hanging. The flame on his bony tail was dark purple with a black core. Blaze was missing a lot of things. Parts of his tail, stomach, arms, and legs. He weakly growled at me. I was completely paralyzed by fear. Blaze weakly held the Everstone before dropping at my feet. The Everstone was never taken away from him since I got in the game. Never. The Charmander's head slowly looked at the Everstone, slowly looked back up at me. Every time this Charmander moved, cracking and ripping noises were heard. So seeing the decayed Pokemon slowly stare at me was mentally scarring. For several seconds, Blaze stared at me with an odd look, almost sorrowful at the same time. Finally, the silence was broken. Blaze's eye sockets slowly began to leak drops of blood at the pace of tears. The words that he spoke to me, I will never forget.
You could have saved me. Instead, you gave up on me. I waited so patiently for your return, Master. For 9 years, I waited. Not a single thing to hear or do. I just waited. You quit using me in battle. After a ghost in Lavertown Tower scared me. Why? We could have made it easily through the tower. But you gave up and left me for 9 years. Those ghosts in the tower terrorize me, hurt me. Did you see what they have done to me? They hurt me. Did you see what they have done to me? I am no longer a happy, living, lovable Charmander. I am decayed, like how your heart is decayed. You did never think of me. I was a one and useless to you. Those ghosts tormented me. The same way I'm threatening you now. Why are you scared of me? You loved me unconditionally when you were younger. I am no different. Other from my physical appearance. If you cannot love me anymore, I am forced to make your fate the same as mine. Seeing you are completely frightened with how I appear to you.
At this point, I threw a large metal pole from my broken bed at the Charmander. This broke his jaw completely off. The Charmander somehow managed to speak again.
My goodness, that hurt. I see now you have no affection for me whatsoever. You want me gone. I see how it is. Now you too will see how I feel.
Blaze slowly limped towards me, blood spilling from his gaping mouth. Could not escape. I was pushed into a corner. Blaze's eyes were actually blazing. A faint, sad-looking blue flame in each eye socket. Stared at a decayed creature. But I was too scared to scream. Blaze continued to limp towards me, arms open, as if asking for a hug.
Love me! Why don't you love me anymore, Master? Why can't you not see every man loyal?
Love me! I pushed the Charmander away. Instead of stumbling back, he slid. It's unnatural. His feet remained on the ground, but he slid backwards a bit. At this point, the flame was blazing red. Blaze turned to running quickly and grabbed my arm. He started dragging me closer into the cloud of mist. I was screaming. Blaze was crying loudly. He was finally dragged into the mist and all I could see is white. A large flash of light occurred on the screen. I shut my eyes tightly, but I soon wake up. Lying on the bed with the game of the start menu instead of seeing the regular Charmander. I saw Blaze. He was not decayed. He was the same as he was since I played Red version live. I quickly took the whole game in the Game Boy and threw him out up the outstairs window. After they were crushed and shattered, I took the pieces and burned them. The flame was black and purple, like the same color on Blaze's decaying tail. I took the ashes and put them in a lake. Now the lake is forever shrouded in the same white mist every day. No matter the weather, the mist is so thick you cut it with a knife. Kids, don't lose your old Pokemon games.